a project that's looking to solve the blockchain trilemma: speed, scalability, and decentralization. Can you guess what it is? They're actually looking to do this with 1 second finality and can process thousands of transactions per second. This project also has a vibrant DeFi ecosystem with over 200 different dApps. And can you guys guess what it is? Well, I'm gonna go ahead and spoil the surprise. It's Fantom. In today's KuCoin DigiDive, we're gonna be talking about Fantom and how it's looking to solve the blockchain trilemma and what you can do on Fantom. If you guys wanna go ahead and get 20% off trading fees, there's a link in the description below to get access to KuCoin and get the discounted trading fees. How does the Fantom technology work? Well, it actually works like a DAG, directed acyclic graph. And basically how you can look at this is like a spider web. It has just different points. Like say, for example, this is one node point, this is another, and they can all validate their own transactions. Now, there are multiple protocols that function with a DAG technology, like Constellation, Nano, Banano. There's a bunch of different protocols that do have DAG technology, but the difference is Fantom has Lachesis. Lachesis is Fantom's ABFT consensus algorithm. You can basically look at Lachesis as the method to the madness. Lachesis is going to organize these different transactions where you have separate nodes that are validating their own transactions. Lachesis basically aligns all the different nodes and brings consensus between the different nodes. So let's say, for example, this node is processing its own transactions, this one's processing its own transactions, and Lachesis will bring consensus between the two, so that way everyone is on a level playing field on the blockchain. The reason why Lachesis is important is because if you don't have this consensus event that occurs, you have one node processing these transactions and this node processing these transactions. How do we know what is actually confirmed on the blockchain without the nodes coordinating with each other? And that's what Lachesis is doing. Now, this is different from other blockchains in general. Let's give, for example, Bitcoin. You can have a miner that is mining a block that isn't going to be validated. As in, there could be one chain that's this long and one chain that's this long. They could be validating these blocks and not really realize until maybe an hour, 2 hours later when they figure out the longest chain is this one. And now all the miners go over to this. Lachesis just gets rid of the inefficiencies and it allows the chain to have faster finality. So Fantom's finality is around 1 second, whereas Bitcoin's is actually 60 minutes. So it takes 6 confirmations. So Fantom is much faster and more efficient. And this isn't even talking about the transactions per second, but we're just talking about the finale. Let me go ahead and play this cool little trailer so it can kind of give a visual of what I just described.
The problem with previous blockchain platforms is that they are based on older technologies that don't scale. With Bitcoin, you have to wait 30 to 60 minutes at the store for the payment to clear. With Fantom, your payments are received faster than you can swipe your credit card. Fantom is a network of custom blockchains designed for speed, security, and scalability. These features allow users to create applications that can be used in the real world, such as payments, central bank digital currencies, storing sensitive medical data, and much more. How? Fantom fixes the issue at the root with Lachesis, an innovative consensus mechanism and the engine that powers the blockchain. Lachesis is much faster and cheaper than previous technologies, but still extremely secure. The combination of speed, security, and scalability makes Fantom perfect for banks, governments, and other organizations that haven't been convinced by other blockchains. With Lachesis at the core, thousands of networks can be deployed on Fantom with no compromise in speed or security. Each network can be customized to specific needs, forming a fully decentralized ecosystem, all secured by staking FTM. Whether you need a private network for sensitive medical or financial data, or a public network for verifying the results of an election, Fantom makes it a reality. We believe everyone should be part of that reality. Create your future.
All right, so now that you guys saw that trailer, now you guys got a bit of an understanding on Fantom, let's go and visit their website. So as you guys can see here, this is a little overview of the website. Performance matters. In fact, these guys also are sponsoring Formula F1 Racing. You guys can see the little logo on some of the drivers and race cars in general, but that is what they're catering to. They're catering towards speed. If you guys have not experienced a Fantom transaction or played around the DeFi protocols, I highly recommend you guys do so. It is an extremely fast blockchain. Speed, security, and scalability. Solving the blockchain trilemma. Now here are a list of a bunch of different dApps that they have listed on their protocol. Some of them that you probably already know, like Curve, 1inch, Paraswap. These are pretty common ones that are also on Ethereum and other chains as well. Here's a quick overview of the TVL on DeFi Llama. DeFi Llama has a list of all the top protocols. As you guys can see here, they have over $3.26 billion in TVL on Fantom. They were at its peak around $8 billion, which was maybe about a month ago. And you guys can see here the list of all the different protocols here. The list goes on and on and on. Remember, it's over 220 dApps. So you guys can take a look into these and see what they are. I'll leave a link in the description below so you guys can do some browsing as well. Now, some of my favorite dApps I like to play around with are Spooky Swap, Spirit Swap, and Tomb. The reason why I like these is these yield farming protocols allow both the experience and beginner DeFi user to be able to use their platform. So if you guys look on Spooky Swap, the beginner would just be able to swap into any token that they want, say for example, Fantom to Spooky token or the Boo token. You can do this at a market order. However, a more experienced DeFi user would want to use limit orders. That way they can buy at the price that they want. The difference between a limit order and a market order is if you do a market order, it's going to buy what's on the market. In a limit order, you can say, oh, look, Boo is at $8. I only want to buy it when it's $5. So you can put a limit order, and if it dips down to $5, you get the buy on. So that's just something you can use on Spooky Swap. And then, of course, you have the common farms where you can actually deposit USDC and Boo and just create an LP pair and get paid to provide liquidity. Bear in mind of impermanent loss and keeping in mind being a pool too. The pool tool just means that you are holding the token that's being emitted as farming rewards. What's also really interesting is all the Boo that you earn, you can bring it over to Boo and stake your Boo, and then you can also deposit your X Boo, which is your stake Boo, and earn additional tokens. So it's pretty fun. It's a cool way to earn different token rewards as well as an APR and reward their different users. Then you even have something that's a little more degen, like Tomb Finance. Tomb Finance is pretty cool because it's an algo coin that's pegged to Fantom. And I'm not going to dig into the protocol itself, but the TLDR is that you can earn some crazy high APRs. We're talking, it used to be like 2,000-3,000% per year. It's crazy. Now it's only like 100%, but still, that's pretty crazy being able to earn it on a Fantom peg coin. The reason this is important is because this gets rid of impermanent loss. Now, obviously, there are other risks associated with the Tomb token. Make sure you guys take a look into the protocol itself before aping in. I'm just showing you guys a couple of features and dApps and protocols that are on the Fantom ecosystem that I really like and I think are interesting. Now, it's the same experience that you know and love on Ethereum and all the other chains, except the transaction speeds are much faster. And of course, you have your own native experiences on Fantom that aren't on other chains. For example, like Tomb Finance. Yes, this is like basis cash on Ethereum, but it's with a twist. So it's pretty cool. Now let's go and get into the tokenomics of Fantom. This is the initial distribution of the supply. There is an initial supply of 3.175 billion tokens. We'll go ahead and show you guys the supply schedule in a second, but you can see here 25% to the founders and projects, 41% to investors, and 32% to pre-mine rewards and airdrops. Let me go ahead and show you guys the supply distribution here. You guys can see here around 2025 is supposed to be when all of the Fantom tokens are minted or at least earned. And this also shows the distribution as well, where the block rewards is this pink one. So this is what's being given out as the staking rewards. Fantom is a proof of stake blockchain. So how the network is secured is through staking, and the validators are rewarded with Fantom incentives. You have a 335 million Fantom incentive program with Gitcoin grants. So this is basically rewarded to different developers that are building on Fantom and meet certain qualifications, as in a certain amount of TVL, amount of certain time they've had that TVL, etc. You guys can see the full list here on the Fantom blog. I'll leave a link in the description, especially if you guys are a developer, so you guys can look into this as well. Here are some of the key features of Fantom. The first is speed. It has near 1 second finality, which is blazing fast. It's one of the fastest of all the other chains. The only other one that's similar is Avalanche, but still, in this scenario, Fantom is actually even faster than Avalanche. Scalability. It is extremely scalable. If it's looking to expand the amount of transactions it can take per second, you just add on additional nodes. And also, being that it's a DAG, these nodes can actually sync up with each other through Lachesis. And yes, it does take time. You can't just throw out a million nodes and have fun with it, because as you add more nodes, each of the additional nodes need to be synced with the blockchain. It also has smart contract capabilities. This is really important because now it has more use cases for the Fantom token. So overall, what are my thoughts on Fantom in general? I really like the vibrant DeFi ecosystem that it has. This brings more utility to the Fantom token in general. And with all of these smart contract platforms, the more utility you have for the token, the better. A good example of this is Ethereum. It has a lot of utility for DeFi. It has a lot of utility for NFTs. It also has additional utility as being a reserve asset, similar to Bitcoin. Some may argue against that. Some may argue for that. Either way, it is actually a deflationary token. As long as the transaction amounts and fees exceed the amount that's being given as token rewards. Now, going back to Fantom, it also has the EIP-1559-like mechanics, to where a portion of the gas fees are burned. This just goes to the scarcity of the Fantom token. So having more of it used in DeFi, having more of it burned, they will have their own, they do have their own NFT ecosystem on Fantom. They'll also have GameFi. I think this creates a really bullish scenario on Fantom, and being that it has an extremely low TVL to market cap ratio. What does this mean? What this means is that there is more TVL than the Fantom market cap. This is crazy. If you look at Ethereum, Ethereum actually has more market cap than it has TVL. So what that means is the price of Ethereum and its total market cap is worth more than all the DeFi assets that are on chain. Fantom is the complete opposite. In fact, it's hovering around 0.65 to the ratio, as in there is about $4 billion in TVL and the Fantom market cap is sitting around $3 billion. In comparison to Ethereum, Ethereum sits at a 4.55 market cap to TVL. So almost a 6x of what Fantom is in comparison. Now, this doesn't mean it's all going to be hunky-dory for Fantom and it's going to be up only. There are going to be risks associated with this. It is a newer DeFi ecosystem. It is not as battle-tested as Ethereum, and it also has dependencies on the overall market. Whereas Bitcoin and Ethereum usually follow each other, or at least Ethereum follows Bitcoin. Fantom, on the other hand, has its own dependencies, where Bitcoin and Ethereum, if those are going down, Fantom usually goes down as well with the overall crypto market. It's a reflexive asset to those two. So Fantom has to have, yes, if Bitcoin and Ethereum are doing well, Fantom also has to do well in order to do well. Whereas one of the bigger assets like Ethereum, it's just Bitcoin having to do well. One other thing I also like about Fantom is that it has EVM compatibility. What this means is that it's easier for other chains like Avalanche, Binance Smart Chain, Ethereum, it's easier for them to port over to Fantom. Simply by adding the chain to your MetaMask, you can use the Spooky Swap bridge. And depending on the token that you're bringing in and from the certain ecosystem, it has zero fees to get in, especially from Ethereum. If you're bringing ETH from Ethereum over into Fantom, it's actually going to charge you nothing. Of course, you have the Ethereum gas fee, but even then, it's only like $8 to $10. But you know what they say, without risk, there's no reward. Anyways, guys, thanks for tuning in, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this KuCoin digi dive. And if you guys want to go ahead and get started trading with KuCoin, there's a link in the description below where you guys can get 20% off trading fees. If you guys want to see some of our previous videos, there's one here, 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 and like somewhere.